Trigonometry Units Section 2 Introduction. We're going to take a look at labeling the triangles. Trigonometry depends upon being able to precisely specify a particular side or sides of a right triangle. This means that each side must have a unique name. When we first looked at a right triangle, we named the longest side hypotenuse and left the generic term leg for the two sides that make up the right angle. From now on, we will use three words to identify each side of the right triangle. And those three sides are hypotenuse, opposite, and adjacent. To do this, we first need to designate a reference angle. Think of the reference angle as an anchor or the home base. You may choose either of the acute angles to be your reference angle. If we start with A as our reference angle, the next step is to identify the opposite side. It is located directly opposite the reference angle. We'll next identify and label the hypotenuse. It's located directly opposite the right angle. And you could do this first when you're labeling your right triangle. That leaves us with the third remaining unlabeled side, and we will call this the adjacent side. Now, if our reference angle had been here on the bottom of the triangle with angle B, it's acting as our home base. And if we're looking for the opposite side, it is the side or the leg that is opposite this angle. So here on the left-hand side, this leg has the specific name of opposite. The hypotenuse is not going to change regardless of which reference angle we choose. It's always the longest side. It is always the side opposite the right angle. And it leaves that third unlabeled side as the adjacent. Let's look at an example. If we designate angle A as our reference angle, our first mission will be to label the side opposite it. This is going to be on the right-hand side. The hypotenuse is the side opposite the right angle, and the remaining unlabeled side is the adjacent side. You will find further practice on labeling the sides of a right triangle on page 11.